What's up, Vinyl Community? It's your boy Chris coming at you live, as always, from the Man Cave on Halloween morning. Probably about 1:30 in the morning. As of recently, as you guys have seen, I've been unboxing a lot of grails on my channel live for you guys. And this video, this time around, will be no different. I'm going to unbox another one for you guys. Arrived earlier today. Very excited about this one that I've wanted for quite some time. It's one that's a little bit more off the radar than your average jazz grail or spoiler alert, or your average blue note. Not as highly coveted, just as rare, probably rarer than most titles, especially in good condition, because it seems like the people who dig it really dig it. Is usually when you find these copies, they're well played, well beat. But earlier in the year, actually, my boy Dylan at Noble Records has gotten himself a copy. I tried to talk him out, talk him into selling it to me, but he had played it first. And a lot of times with a lot of these records, if I know Dylan's gonna, if I think he might dig them, I try to get him before he plays them. Because some of them, once he plays them, and that's one of them, it's big on percussion, big Afro beat, spoiler alert on this one. And without further ado, let me go ahead and unbox it for you guys. Arriving in the mail here today from Los Angeles, California. Here lately, I seem to have a knack for grabbing these records off of these sellers from LA. Not intentionally, of course, just the way it's played out. Every time I do these unboxing videos, there's always a moment where I think to myself, holy hell, what if I pull this out and it's beat? Or what if it's cracked or broken? Then I guess we just all experience it together now, wouldn't we? But that doesn't appear to be the case so far with this one. Looks like there's a bonus record thrown in on this one. Okay, cool. Alright. The bonus record is Bobby McFerrin, Spontaneous Inventions. So thank you to the seller. I appreciate you. But let's get to what we're here to see. And what we're here to see is Solomon Alori in his Afro Drum Ensemble, African High Life. This, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, is an original stereo pressing on Blue Note. Pretty damn clean, really, if you ask me. Splat out. Solomon Alori does vocals, penny whistle, talking drum guitar, Chief Bay on conga, Josiah Alori, Sakara drum, cowbell, Robert Crowder conga, Chicory cowbell, Montego Joe conga, Garvin Masseau conga, xylophone, cowbell, Jay Berliner guitar, Hosea Taylor on alto, flute, and Ahmed Abdul Malik on bass. I think I read everybody's names correctly without butchering them, I believe. And because you guys know how I like it, Will, let's go ahead and get you a look at that wax. Splat out. Original stereo pressing. She is a beauty. Yeah, not too damn bad at all. Van Gelder Stout, absolutely beautiful copy. I'm very, very, very thrilled to have this in the collection. And furthermore, I want to take this opportunity, because I know not everybody here is familiar with the work of Solomon Alori. Take this opportunity to bring up to you that Solomon Alori was born in 1934, was an American citizen, I believe, as of 1958. Anybody here who has any information contrary to what I just said, please feel free to correct me. I don't mind at all. It's all about getting the correct information out there to the masses. and still with us as of my findings. As far as I know, as far as my research has gone, is still with us, still living to this day. Again, anybody who knows any different on that one, please drop me a line. But as far as I know, still with us. And furthermore, what's most interesting to me is only ever played on two albums. And I've got them both sitting right here in this room. And that, of course, is his Blue Note solo debut and only solo album that I've just unboxed for you guys, Solomon Allure, and his Afro Drum Ensemble African High Life, which my copy is an original stereo pressing, and one that I actually showed you guys earlier this year, The African Beat by Art Blakey, in which he plays on. And this is, of course, an original mono pressing that I grabbed earlier this year. Super clean, one of the cleanest original Blue Notes in my collection that I'm thrilled to have, absolutely thrilled to have. Wow. But that's just amazing to me, because it's two percussion masterpieces that the great Solomon Allure played on, his debut on Blue Note and The African Beat by Art Blakey and the Afro Drum Ensemble, only to never be heard from again in a jazz sense, which is just astounding to me. I don't know how somebody plays on two wonderful pieces of work like that one and just if anybody's got any more information on Solomon Allure, if you guys would post it in the comments or anything, or send them to me, email them to me, whatever, I'd be very, very, very thrilled to find out a little bit more about the, I guess, very elusive Solomon Allure. And I cannot even begin to tell you guys just how thrilled I am to now own a copy of African High Life by Solomon Allure and his Afro Drum Ensemble. It's another grail in the mail. It's another wonderful addition to the collection. And I can't even begin to tell you guys how excited I am to have it. The great Solomon Allure, as far as I know, still with us. Getting ready to be burning up a platter here in a minute. And I hope all of you guys are having a wonderful weekend. I hope everybody has a wonderful Halloween. For those of you with kids, hope you get them out trick-or-treating, everything like that. And I hope everybody stays safe. And I hope this weekend you guys are getting some grails. You guys are spinning some records and enjoying your time with your family. I really hope so. But very thrilled to be holding this. And until next time, until next video, keep dropping that EV, guys. Babanja, 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 Babanja